All right. Now that we have all been served, I would just like to reintroduce Colleen Massey from Mass College of Pharmacy and her two students, May and Wee. And we're very happy and honored to have them here today because they have a lot of good information for us about Medicare Part D. So welcome.
Thank you. Thank you, Marcia, for having us today. And thank you for everybody for welcoming us and chatting and allowing us to get to know you a little bit more, too, and how we can help you. So today we're going to be talking about the ABCs of Medicare Part D. And I'm Colleen Massey. I'm the Director of Operations at the Pharmacy Outreach Program at the Mass College of Pharmacy. And today I have May, who's one of our third year pharmacy students. And I have Wee, and he's also one of our third year pharmacy students. So they're currently rotating with us at the Pharmacy Outreach Program to learn more about what we do and how we help the public. And our hopes is that they learn a lot about financial programs that help the public so that when they go and work at a community site, they'll really be able to help people that come into the pharmacy. You know, when somebody goes to fill a prescription at the pharmacy and their claim doesn't go through, they know what to do. They know who to refer to, and they know how to help that person. So that's our aim with our students at Pharmacy Outreach, is to get them to be more knowledgeable about the programs in Massachusetts that help with the cost of medicines, as well as develop an empathy so that they understand the people that they're working with. Okay. So I just put together some points. At the end of this presentation, you'll know the services of the Pharmacy Outreach Program. You'll know how to reach our program and how we can help you. You'll be able to describe how Medicare Part D works. We're going to go over that today and talk about Medicare Part D and what it does for you. You're going to understand the importance of having a Medicare Part D evaluation on an annual basis. We're going to go over why it's important to have somebody to look at your Medicare Part D plan to make sure it's the best one for you for the upcoming benefit year. And we're also going to go over a couple of programs. One is a Massachusetts program called Prescription Advantage, and also the Extra Help program through the Social Security Administration that helps with the cost of medicines with the Medicare Part D plan. So these two programs fill in some of the gaps of the Medicare Part D plan for people with lower incomes. If you have any questions as I'm going along, feel free to stop me and stop the students. If you have questions about what they're presenting, we'd be happy to answer your questions when we go along. So what is pharmacy outreach? I know our pharmacists have been out here in the last couple of months, and you've probably heard this before, but I'm going to go over it again for the people that weren't here. Pharmacy outreach is a free service at MCPHS University. We started back in 2001 when we applied for a contract through the Executive Office of Elder Affairs in the state of Massachusetts to be the pharmacy outreach program for the whole entire state. We operate a toll-free line that you can call in and ask questions about your medicines, as well as learn about programs and get assistance with applying to programs that help with the cost of medicines. We also provide a lot of research around medications, how they work. We screen medication profiles for drug interactions, for medications that may contribute to falls. We also provide assistance applying to programs like Prescription Advantage. We research programs in your community that offer medications at a lower cost. We also do a lot of community programs like this one today. We'll go out to different health fairs in the community. We'll provide medication counseling at different senior centers, and also give presentations on programs that help with the cost of medicines. So I just added in a couple of pictures to spice up the presentation a little bit. I thought the text was a little heavy, so I thought I'd give some pictures of different programs that we've done in the community. So this one over here is a program in Southbridge that we did with an older adult support group. And then over here is a health fair that we had. And over in the picture on the bottom, we were talking to people about the Medline Plus program. And I know that we did a program out here in Uxbridge where we educated older adults about how to find reputable health information on the internet. And that's what our students are doing there. So how do you reach pharmacy outreach? We have a toll-free number that you can call Monday through Friday, 8:30 to 5. It's also on the little cards that we handed out in the brochures. It's on every piece of literature that we have. It's a toll-free number. Again, we're there Monday through Friday, 8:30 to 5. So if you have a question about a medication that was recently prescribed and you forgot to ask your physician in the doctor's office because you're kind of confused. I mean, I go into the doctor's office and I'm like a deer in the headlights, you know? What are you saying? And then I get home and I think about all those things that I wanted to ask. If you have a question about a medication and you can't get in touch with your physician, our office and our clinical pharmacists would be happy to answer those questions for you. And we can also help you if you have a question about Medicare Part D, how it works. You know, maybe you heard about this low-cost purchasing program at Hannaford's. We can research that for you and find out what medications are on those lists. We also suggest generic alternatives. So maybe you're struggling with the cost of a medication, but you want to know if there's an alternative in that drug class that costs a lot less than that brand name medication. We can do that research for you. Okay. So I'm going to pass the mic to May, who's going to talk to you about Medicare Part D.
Thank you. So, hi everyone, I'm May. I will be presenting Medicare Part D. So, what is Medicare Part D? So, it's just a prescription insurance. Oh, I'm sorry. Okay, it's just prescription insurance that is funded through Medicare. And then it's covered the FDA approved drugs that's in the United States. So, those include drugs, biologics, insulins, and supplies. So they all available, like the vaccines is covered by the Medicare Part D, but some of them could cover by Medicare Part B. So in that case, Medicare Part D is not going to cover those in Medicare Part B.
So Medicare Part D is a prescription drug plan funded by the government, and it covers all FDA approved medications. It includes drugs. And it includes some vaccinations.
So the medications that exclude from Medicare Part D include anorexia, weight loss or weight gain medications, erectile dysfunction drugs, fertility drugs, cosmetic and lifestyle drugs, medication that's used for cough and cold, prescription vitamins, minerals, over-the-counter medications.
So if your physician writes a prescription for a vitamin for you and you take that to the pharmacy and you wonder why that's not covered on your Part D plan, it's because it's excluded from the Medicare Part D plan. So even if a prescriber is writing a prescription, it doesn't necessarily mean your drug plan's going to cover it. Okay, so if you have any questions about that, we can help you do that research as well.
So how do you get Medicare Part D? So then you need to have Medicare Part A and B, and then you need to enroll when it's eligible. And then not maintaining credible coverage. So if you could get penalized if you not enroll in Medicare Part D. So the initial, when you first become eligible, you're gonna have 7 months enrollment. And then the annual open enrollment is from October 15 to December 7. And then they have some kind of special enrollment. It depends on the plan. And do you have standalone Part D plan or Part C plan? I'll explain more details in the later slides.
So we just want to stress the fact that the Medicare Part D open enrollment period for people that are already enrolled in Medicare is right now. So starting October 15th, it's really important to have somebody look at your Part D plan to make sure it's the best option for you.
So that's four parts of Medicare. So Part A, it covers hospital. Part B covers medical service, like you go to see a doctor, like a doctor visit. And then Part C and D, so Part C including everything, but I will explain more details, and Part D is a standalone prescription coverage.
So again, you get your Medicare Part D coverage through a standalone Part D plan or through a Medicare Advantage plan that's also considered Medicare Part C.
So what is Part D? So it covers the outpatient medications and it's managed by private insurance, but it's contracted with Medicare. And then you have many options available and they all look different. So we will have an example for that.
So Medicare Part D is a program that's funded by the federal government, but the money goes out to private companies. So the benefit that you get as Medicare Part D is administered by private companies.
So the Part C, it include A, B, and D. So then it managed by a private insurance company as well, just like a Part D. But then they have different cost structure and it's different from the Part D plan. And they all include in one benefit, like hospital, medical service, medications. They might also include like vision, hearing, or dental. So it's all included in one plan, but Part D is like standalone.
So Medicare Part C are those like Tufts Medicare preferred plans, maybe the Blue Cross Blue Shield HMOs. And like May said, some of the benefits of those Medicare C or Advantage programs that have your medical and your prescription and your hospital insurance all in one benefit is that they provide some additional services like maybe a fitness benefit, maybe vision care, maybe dental care.
Excuse me?
Yes.
I thought Part C was for mental health.
You thought it was for mental health?
That's what I always thought it was for.
Oh, okay. It has coverage for mental health built into it, but it's for more than that.
Okay.
So here just the...
Maybe... Didn't come
yeah, it didn't come through.
That's okay. So we just wanted to illustrate that you can get your Medicare D or C benefit through a lot of different companies, and what might be good for your neighbor isn't necessarily good for you. So it's really important to meet with somebody to talk to them about all the different options that are available to you.
It's just like you pay a lot of money, like for the premiums, for the deductible, but then doesn't mean that like it's the best plan for you. Like it might not cover your medications. So that's why you have to look for which plan is best for you, and you have to pay, like you might not need to pay for the deductible or premium, and it covers all your medications. So pay more doesn't mean that it's the best for you. So for the cost of Medicare, so Part C, you have monthly premium, co-payment or co-insurance, but it varies. And for a standalone Part D, the monthly premium range from $14.60 to $127.70. So the co-payment, co-insurance difference as well.
So like May said, there are many different Medicare Part D plans. You might be taking a couple of generic, can everybody hear me back there? Okay. You might be taking a couple of generic medications, and the $14 plan is the best one for you. You don't need the Cadillac plan with the $127 premium. But maybe that one is better for somebody else who has an extensive drug list.
So I gotta tell you what those mean, like what's the definition for those terms. So premium is just a monthly payment that you have to pay in order to be in the plan. And then the deductible is just that how much you have to pay, like the annually, before the insurance kick in. The coverage gap or donut hole is just that when the benefit stops after a certain spending limit is reached, and the catastrophic coverage it begins when out of pocket spending. Can you hear me? Oh, okay. So when out of pocket spending limit is reached. And the formulary is just like the list. It depends on what insurance you have. Like every insurance, they have a different formulary list. So they have generic and brand, and they change it every year. So you cannot say, "Oh, last year's paid for it. Why not this year's? Why this year's not covered?" So you have to look at the list to make sure, because every year changed. You want to make sure whatever you pay for it, like last year, you want to make sure that they have it in the formulary. If not, maybe you want to find out a different plan. So like last year, like the generic or brand, they do cover, but only pay for like $2. But then this year, you have paid like $50. It all depends. So that's why you want to find out thoroughly what's happening right for next year.
So does anybody here have a standalone Medicare Part D plan?
Could you get me a milk?
Yeah. So do you ever hit the point in the plan where it stops paying and your prices go up?
Well, I haven't hit it yet. I haven't turned that in yet.
Okay.
I have some
out. Okay. So that's called the donut hole.
Yeah.
When your price suddenly jumps up from paying maybe co-payments to paying 50% of the cost of the medication, that's when you've hit that coverage gap or donut hole and the price goes up quite significantly. That's a lot different than what you would experience when you were working and had commercial insurance, because most insurance plans don't have a big gap in the middle of them. So when you turned 65 and went on Medicare, it was a big surprise to have that high cost right there in the middle of your benefit. Does anybody have any questions about these different categories that are part of Medicare Part D?
And we gotta give you the next slide.
Yes.
Who determines the copay?
So the plan determines the copay. So the individual plan, if you have Humana or Blue Cross Blue Shield or Cigna, they determine what your copayment is going to be.
If I go from one pharmacy to another, might I find a difference in the copay?
You might find it a big difference. Yes, because each plan contracts with a certain pharmacy chain, and there have been pretty big differences between Walgreens, CVS, a supermarket, things like that. So it's really important for us when we evaluate you to have that information. Where do you prefer to go? Where are you willing to go? And we can talk to you about that too.
The pharmacy won't tell you how much the copay is unless you have a prescription.
Correct.
Yeah, because they have to run through the system first, like the run through the computer, and then they can tell you the price, how much it's going to be.
So the pharmacy, the technicians and the pharmacists aren't necessarily educated on all of the different plans. They don't know how much the price is going to be until they run it a claim through, like May said. Mm-hmm.
So you're just buying blind, you can't shop.
Right. So you can go on the Medicare website and check it out. You can go to your plan's website and find out the price. Or you can call us and ask us and we can find that for you.
So
Medicare Part D, they will bill Medicare, but most often you also get very low co-payments there if you're a member of that community health center, probably $3 and $1 for your medications, because you might have secondary insurance like Mass Health or Health Safety Net. Yeah.
Okay, so this is for the cost sharing in 2017. So is going up. So the deductible you had to pay for is $400. So you had to, in the beginning, so you had to pay for $400 in order for the insurance to kick in. And the initial coverage limit is $3,700 in total drug costs. So the insurance and the patient both have to pay for this much.
And this is really detailed information about a standard Part D benefit, but there are many variations on this. So don't put this information to memory. It's not something that you necessarily need to know, but you need to know that this could be the situation that you're in.
In some Part D plans, they may have a different numbers. So the coverage gap, so the donut hole would be 40% of the brand name and 51% of generic. So for instance, like your drug is brand, it's $100. So you have to pay for $40 for that, but then if it's generic, then it would be $51 that you have to pay out of that $100. Catastrophic coverage begins, it's $8,071 and $71. So you have to pay for like out of pocket for $8,071 in order for the catastrophic cost range to kick in. For the total drug cost, sorry. So the greater of 5% or 3.3 generic $8.25 for the brand.
This is where I always get, this part is kind of tricky, and I still don't completely understand it. So, the initial coverage limit, once you've expended and your insurance has expended a combined $3,700, you could potentially then be in what's known as the donut hole?
Yeah.
Yes.
Am I jumping the gun on this question? So this is where I get tripped up, and I still get tripped up after 15 years of being exposed to this information. So then when catastrophic coverage begins, you've paid the difference between the $3,700 and the $8,071? How does that math work? My brain does not do math. So if your drug costs, you've maxed out and you're in the donut hole, do you get to count that $3,700 or do you have to start over again to get to the $8,071 before the catastrophic kicks in?
No.
Am I being articulate?
Yeah, that's added up. So like the initial coverage limit, so it's including how much you pay and also the insurance. So it's combined, so that's $3,700 for the total drug cost. So then, and then later on, so you're gonna hit the donut hole. So after the initial coverage limit, you're gonna hit the donut hole. And then the donut hole, you have to pay for like 40% of the brand and then 51% of generic, that is out of pocket. Right, and then after that, so you have to be in the donut hole for until you hit like $8,000 for the total drug cost, then you're gonna pay just the 5% of that, of the total drug cost.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So please forgive me, but so now when you're paying the either 40%, the $40 on $100 prescription,
yeah.
Mm-hmm. Or the 51,
mm-hmm.
You get to add that to the $3,700.
So you just keep on adding. So $3,700 plus the donut hole,
okay.
And then you wish to the $8,000.
I thought that's how it worked. Thank you for confirming that for me. Because I wasn't sure if you had to kind of scroll back now and then have another
$8,071. No. Yeah, it's too expensive.
So you're at $3,700, and now you're in the donut hole,
mm-hmm.
And then what you pay, and then what Medicare pays gets added, and then once you get to 87, you've worked through the donut hole, you're in catastrophic, and now you
pay 5% of the total drug costs.
Yeah, so think about it as it starts in January. So if your plan starts in January, that's when it starts ticking. And you go to the pharmacy and you fill a prescription, and a claim goes through to your insurance company. Okay, the full cost, the full retail cost goes towards that donut hole number. And then you go again and you go again. All that goes towards meeting that donut hole number and that catastrophic number. Okay, so it just keeps ticking along.
Very good.
And then you go through the different phases of your benefit. So some people might hit the donut hole in March, but some might in October.
So the goal is to get to that hole, right?
You don't want to. You don't
if
want
you
to.
Have other coverage like prescription advantage, yeah. It sometimes is good to go to the donut hole. Because sometimes if you have prescription advantage, and we'll get into that, your costs are lower than what you were previously paying.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you for the question.
So you said that the full retail cost, not what you're paying, but the full retail cost goes toward that $3,700?
Correct.
What about your premium?
No.
It doesn't add to it for the premium. It's separate. It's just that like when the cost of the medication is very expensive, like $2,000. So like you couldn't go in and out the donut hole very often. So in that case, you might want to have like other like foundation program to help you with the donut hole, or they might have like some kind of like they might give you some kind of money like in a different foundations or manufacturer. So like you can ask us about it. We can help you with that. And if not, then you can go with like the prescription advantage. They can help because it's keep on it's who's gonna talk about it. So I'm just telling you that prescription advantage can help you to get out of the donut hole.
So some people that we talk to, you know, in January, because they're taking a medication like Humira, which is very high cost, they might go from the deductible to the donut hole all in 1 month because their medication is that much, it costs that much money. So we look to other programs that help with the cost of medications, like foundations, like maybe the Arthritis Foundation can help somebody out with the cost of that medication.
So who are you going to talk about the case example?
Hello? Can you hear me back there, or I need to speak louder maybe? So this is example of what we do at our pharmacy outreach. So pretend like we have a case where we have an elderly patient, 65-year-old, that newly to Medicare, and the list of medication taken here at are atorvastatin for cholesterol, lisinopril for blood pressure, and Advair for like, you know, breathing problem, for instance. And then we input the information, every information on your Medicare card, and then with the effective date, the your date of birth, and then this is what we get, like compared to two company, where we have Envision and Blue Cross Blue Shield. And then we're gonna look at the premium, which you can see here is like 14 versus 100 and something. But then the $14, they're gonna have like a plan deductible. That's the amount that you need to pay in order for the plan to kick in. And then we look at the annual cost for premium and the medication too. So it's like $1,000 differences.
So what we wanna illustrate here is that You could enroll in the Blue Cross Blue Shield plan, because we all know Blue Cross Blue Shield in Massachusetts. We're familiar with that name. We have trust in that company. But you're going to pay $1,000 more to get your medications through that plan than you are another plan that's available. So we just want to say that you can change your plan annually, so you're not committed to this plan for life. And it's really important to find one that works with your budget.
Thank you.
Thank you. And then this is the example that we see when you input everything into Medicare.gov. And then we compare their pharmacy that they that close by to your home. So as you can see here, if you were to go to CVS, you're going to pay like $1,400. And then if you go to St. Vincent, it's gonna pay like $1,000. And then if you use mail order, it's gonna be $1,200. So the prefer right here is that we recommend that you should go to St. Vincent, because that's like a $400 or $200, whichever you prefer. And then you can see when you click at each pharmacy, they will tell you which amount you need to pay. So this is the full cost, where they use that amount going toward your donut hole too. And then the deductible, how much you had to pay. So this plan had $260, And then the first month, which you need to pay $346, and then this is going to go in your insurance plan. And then after that, you can pay only $36 per month. And then $1 for generic drug, after a statin and lisinopril. And then they would tell you how much you will pay in the coverage gap as well. So when you're the insurance cover, you pay only $34, but then when you're in a coverage gap, the Advair, which is brand name, so you pay like $137. So it's like 51% of the brand name. And then for the generic, which is atorvastatin, you pay only $3, so it's like 41%. And then the $2, which is the same thing. And then after that, they're gonna tell you catastrophic cost too. So it's like after the 140 when you get out the donut hole, and then you gonna pay $23.
But for this illustration, so this illustration, for this person that only takes these three medications, they're not gonna fall into the coverage gap, correct?
Yeah.
But they're just going to give you that information on the Medicare Plan Finder tool that would be your cost if you were to.
Yeah. So this one don't show. It shows exactly the same, but then we're trying to show you like more information with the plan, and then they show you the premium cost as well. But it doesn't show. Sorry.
So this is like we said, it was an illustration that showed you why this plan costs so much more.
Yeah. So it's like if this were to be shown, you're gonna pay like $1,400 wherever you go, CVS or St. Vincent. But then this slide also shows like a mail order, which you pay like less than $200 if you would prefer the mail plan as well. And then this is an example of the two Medicare plan of the help that you might need. So one of them is through federal, which is called Extra Help, through the Social Security Administration, and one of them, which is Prescription Advantage, this will go through Massachusetts. I will talk more about it on the next slide. For the Extra Help, this will help with the cost of your premium, deductible, or your copay. This will vary, depend on your income and your resource, so they go hand in hand. So if you live by yourself, the income amount is $17,820, and then if you were to marry or you live with your spouse, gonna be $24,000. And then they're gonna access your access as well, so one person $13,000, about $13,000, and then two person gonna be $27,000. But then if you were to get selected in the plan, they're gonna divide into two categories, Extra Help full and partial. If you get full benefit, your price probably $0. Vary on which category you are.
So Extra Help is a great program if you qualify for it. It will provide you with a lot of help with the cost of your medicines. It does have the takeaway messages. It has an income guideline that you have to meet, as well as an asset or resource guideline. So they're going to ask you what your income is, how much money comes into your household, maybe through Social Security, maybe through a pension, things like that. And they're also going to ask how much money you have in the bank. How much money do you have in an IRA? So this program looks at those two financial pieces for you to qualify. But if you do, it's a great program.
I have a question. I have a letter here that I applied for Medicare. It says I'm eligible for help for Medicare prescription drug plan.
Oh, good.
Then now it cuts down to 75% full subsidy for your monthly premium. I don't understand that. I know it's got something to do with my monthly premium.
Yeah, we can talk to you about that. It sounds like you qualify for extra help with a partial subsidy. So that's a good one. Yeah, it's good. Good question.
Oh. And now we have like a Massachusetts plan with Prescription Advantage. This is a secondary insurance add-on to your Medicare Part D. This will kick in when you enter the donut hole. So this vary only in income without the access part. So it's vary in category. It's like 6, S0 to S5. Like I say, depending on what category you are, you might not pay more than $7 or $12 in generic or no more than $12 to $30 in the brand name. Pretend like you have atorvastatin, like this patient, you're gonna pay like $7. But then if you were to take their brand name for some reason you cannot tolerate the generic, so the brand name will be Lipitor, so you pay like $12 or $30, depend on what category. And if you were to be your income, if you live by yourself, it's $35,640 for by yourself. And then if you were to marry or live with your spouse, the income, if you were below $48,060, you don't have no to pay any premium involved. Yeah. And you can enroll by calling the number provided, which is 1-800-243-4636.
So Prescription Advantage is a great state program. Again, like we said, they don't look at assets. So a lot of people might have that nest egg in the bank because they're afraid they aren't going to need a new roof on their house or need a new furnace or something. And that's great. But this program still might qualify because it has higher income guidelines than the extra help program, and they don't look at assets, just the income.
Another benefit of the Rx Advantage is that usually if you're not enrolled in that, you're gonna stay with your plan for like the whole year period. But then that one is like a getaway car where you can like switch the plan, pretend like, you know, now you're taking your medication, but then when later on you pay, like you get a medication like $1,000 which don't cover in your plan, and then you can switch to another plan which it will cover, so you pay less. That's like a wild card for it. You switch it anytime during that period. So you don't have to wait for the open enrollment to come along.
But I'm just wondering how you feel like that was over.
So it might be good for you, but it might not. It's all dependent on your specific situation. And we'd be happy to look at that just to confirm.
Yeah.
But we was talking about how if you're a member of Prescription Advantage, you're entitled to one special enrollment period, or as he called it, a wild card. So if halfway through the year you're prescribed another medication by your healthcare provider, and it's not on the formulary of your drug plan, the medications that drug plan covers, you can switch one time outside of the annual open enrollment period. Okay, so if in January or March, for example, you get prescribed a new medication, you're like, oh darn, I have to wait till the fall to switch my plan. You don't have to if you're a member of Prescription Advantage.
Now, the pool office, is that from the state?
Yes. It's a great program.
Everybody should enroll in Prescription Advantage in addition to your Part D plan.
Yep. So when you go to the pharmacy and you have your Part D plan, so they'll bill your Blue Cross Blue Shield first, and then they'll bill Prescription Advantage. And it might not start working in January because you're not in the donut hole yet, but it will know when to start as long as the pharmacy's been billing both of those insurance companies all along. Okay?
Yep. And at the outreach, we always encourage the elder to get it because the limit income is like $80,000, but then there's out-of-pocket amount vary from $0 to $3,500, I believe. So when you hit that out-of-pocket amount, your copay probably $0. So that always a benefit. So get Prescription Advantage if your income is less than $80,000.
So we also encourage people, if you don't ever fall into the donut hole because your medications are very low cost and you're like, oh, I don't need Prescription Advantage because it's never going to work for me, enroll in it because for most people it's free. And you don't know what you'll be prescribed in the future. You don't know what you're going to be on. So it's really important, if something like this program is great, it's free, they don't look at your assets, they're never going to put a lien on anything. It's just a free program that you should enroll in if you qualify.
Can I ask a little bit of so the Silver Script is just for prescription, right?
Yep.
And that would be medical and prescriptions?
Just prescriptions.
Oh, that's just prescriptions,
yep.
Too. Okay.
Yep. So these are two programs that help with the cost of Medicare Part D. Yeah, and only Medicare Part D.
We'll get a couple people to check that.
And the takeaway message is that always get your plan reviewed by, you know, maybe a sound counselor or our outreach. Review them so you get the best plan. We suggest the best plan that work for you. And then we also look at assist with other benefit. If you need help with your medication, if you need foundation or need help with the copay, we look at those as well. And the phone number, which we have it here, which we will hand out to everyone. You have it on your table, and then you can give us a call anytime. Thank you.
Thank you.
If you have any other question, I will gladly answer it.
Any other questions? I know this is complicated, but I think we covered a lot of good ground today. So I really appreciate it when the students and when Colleen comes out, because that every time I learn a little bit more. And today I was really, it was really clear for me with respect to that period in the donut hole and what counts toward it. You really have to have a good mathematical brain to do this by yourself, and I'll be the first to admit, I don't have that. So this is why I am so grateful to the students and to Colleen, because some of our seniors take a lot of drugs that are very expensive. And I used to think wrongly, that I was doing you a favor if I recommended that you consider a drug plan with no deductible. But we learned today that that's not always the case. Sometimes it's better to pay that deductible up front, because it's going to save you $1,000 in premiums at the end of the day. So you really need to know how to, you know, crunch the numbers and understand how to do that. And this is why I think it's so important to use this great service that's available, because they really are. I like to say that it's a lifeline for all of us. We can call a friend, just like that program that we're all familiar with, right? The $1 million pyramid?
Yeah.
We can call a friend and use a lifeline, and they will help you. It's such a good thing. So thank you so much for coming.
Yeah, and we're going to be available to meet with people today and collect some information, and then we can give you a call and talk to you about your plan if you're interested.
Yeah. I have a question.
Yeah.
What about Canadian drugs?
If it FDA approved in United States, then they we look into it. Yeah.
It has to be FDA approved.
Yes.
And you can, if so, then you can buy it from Canada.
I'm not sure, because Canada have a different healthcare system than ours.
So what we do at Pharmacy Outreach, we don't endorse purchasing your medications in Canada, because they don't go through the same approval process, supposedly, as the ones in the United States. I'm sure the Canadian government isn't trying to hurt their citizens. You know, they're a pretty upstanding country. So if that's the way you need to purchase your medications, then you need to purchase your medications that way. But it's not something that we promote.
Second question. Mm-hmm. Insulin?
Mm-hmm.
Know of any special arrangements for insulin? I mean, that's all. There is no generic.
No generic, but I just recently taught Lee about a program at Walmart.
Yeah, so every time we see that, we're going to recommend, like, for example, Walmart have Relion insulin, which they're only $25 per vial if you are comfortable with injecting yourself. And then we're going to recommend that you check with your provider how you're going to change the dose. Like, for instance, if you have Humalog, you can change to Novalin R, which is Novalin regular, the brand name for insulin. And then they're going to change the doses vary on how much unit you need to inject yourself with. So so the brand name vial probably costs like 300 and something, while you pay only $25 if you were to switch it with your provider in the donut hole. Save you a ton of money.
So we is talking about a program that's offered through Walmart, where you can get vials of insulin through their Relion Novalin products for $25. We get a lot of calls at Pharmacy Outreach when people are in the donut hole and they might not qualify for Prescription Advantage, or maybe they need their insulin immediately and they don't have time to apply for Prescription Advantage. So we'll suggest that they utilize the Rely On program at Walmart, where they can get a vial of insulin for $25. We do tell them that they need to talk to their healthcare provider because it's not a one-to-one switch. Their units will change, and they need to talk to their healthcare provider about what their dose should be.
Yep. And then there is, we also, if you cannot pay the $25, we do look at the foundation. Where they have foundation, a certain amount you spend on the drug, maybe usually 5% of your income on the drug already, you are qualified for them foundation, and then they will cover the copay for you, depending on which foundation are you qualified for. So we do look at all those for you and then give you like a phone number if you need help, or maybe send you an application so you can fill out by yourself if you are more comfortable. So we do adjust to what the elder or which the patient prefer.
Yeah, so there are a lot of foundations that are offered through pharmaceutical companies, or maybe disease, they're disease-specific foundations, and we might suggest that, you know, we can call and help you apply to those programs, and they might offer you your insulin for $25 or something like that.
Any other question? Or we do calculate the donut hole as well. And so if you were to, like, you don't want to go out to the pharmacy and then go in and get your prescription and suddenly your $10 usual monthly payment and then spike up to like $300 and you're like, what's going on? You can give us a call and then we're like, we calculate how much is it, the donut hole going to kick in, like which month, and then you can look for help before that donut hole too. So it's always a benefit.
Yeah, very good point. So we can help you with that for sure.
They'll do the math.
Yeah, all the math. We're going to calculate.
Proactive, because you've done all the hard work for it, and they can spell it all out for you. Mm-hmm. Can't beat it.
Yeah.
You really can't.
Well, thank you for having us. Thank you for having us today and taking the time to listen and learn.
Thank you for coming.
Yeah.
Thank you.